We're starting at the beginning with this demo of Longtail Pro. You can get a 7-day free trial. That's what I'm going to check out right here. So if you click this button, you can get started. Now, I'm including my affiliate link. So if you use my affiliate link, I get a small commission. I truly appreciate it. I'm going to go ahead and fill out this information super fast. As you can see, it's a 7-day trial, and then it's $37 per month after that. They state here in the sort of benefits area, so you get the best SEO research software, which is, of course, debatable. Calculate the keyword profitability, which is interesting. The keyword competitiveness, which some people tout as the most important thing that Longtail Pro does. I have my own feelings on it, and we'll get to that in a minute. You can track your rankings and get custom recommendations and a lot more. Like I said, you could just try it out for free for 7 days. Just remember, if you don't want to be charged, you need to cancel it before the 7 days are up. And if you are ready to do keyword research, 7 days is plenty. If you spend, you know, an hour a day or so over the 7 days, you should be able to get a lot of keyword research done. And frankly, I typically just, you know, do keyword research for a little while, and then I will stop paying for the tool, and I don't need it because you can find a lot of keywords pretty quickly. By the way, if you're interested in Amazon affiliate marketing, go to nichesiteproject.com, click the green button, and I'll send you like 15,000 keywords from successful and profitable Amazon affiliate sites. Additionally, I give you all my tools and templates and a bunch of guides. Get on the email list if you're interested in these kind of sites, and let's get back to Longtail Pro. So boom, I just hit the get started button, and they are just showing me how to use it. So quickly, they have a little chat situation going on. So Heather from Longtail Pro points me towards a boot camp, and you get 7 days of free access to the Longtail Pro boot camp tutorials and so on. I'm not interested in that currently right now, so I'll just click the X. They are guiding us through like what happens. So when you join, you'll be able to do the same thing. So search any keyword to get started, which is cool. So you can just put in the keyword here. And as in our other demos, I will use the same like keyword phrase so we can just get an idea on like what we see. By the way, if you haven't seen the other keyword research tool demos, do check them out. If you're looking for a tool to use, it's probably good to see the inside of each of the tools before you make a decision. Okay. So step one, I'll click here, and then, okay, I'll enter in, I guess, best fly fishing rods. Okay, so 1 out of 5. So Google AdWords suggestions and manual keyword entry, and then it's 20 suggestions per keyword. Okay, that sounds good. I'll just click retrieve and see what we get out of here. So obviously the navigation is straightforward. So we're in the keyword research section now, and I'll talk about the others in a second. So look for green KC for easy ranking. This shows how competitive the keyword is in Google. A green KC score is the easiest to rank for. Use target keyword competitiveness as your guide. Next. Add a domain to improve accuracy, so you'll get a personalized targeted keyword competitiveness guide as well as some important ranking metrics. If you don't have a domain yet, like a lot of us won't have a domain yet if you're doing research, you don't need to worry about it. It'll calculate it for a brand new site. In-depth competition analysis, so you can click on any row to see the SERP for that keyword along with the KC and other metrics for the ranking for each ranking competitor. And last, track your progress. So there's a rank tracker there. So quick note on the KC value, the keyword competitiveness. This is where I have strong opinions. So I think when Longtail Pro first came out and first introduced the KC number, it was pretty valuable. But unfortunately, over time, I think the value of that single number has gone down, right? It's just, there's too many variables out there and there's more and more competition each day. Now, the thing is, the KC number is created and sort of estimated based on other estimates from other tools, so it's many steps away from the actual real data. The problem I have with a KC number is people treat it like gold, right? They treat it like it's 100% right. And there are many affiliates out there who say, yeah, the KC number, if it's about 30 or less, you should be good to go. You could rank it. It works. Now, that may have been true 3 years ago, but times are different now. And I don't think the KC number is as accurate. So maybe it needs a rebalancing. Maybe, you know, a 30 is really more like a 50 or a 60 nowadays. Or maybe some of the factors are just hard to estimate. The thing is, we like to have a single number because it's simple, but it's really not that simple. It's hard to take all those variables and figure out like the actual competitiveness. I talk about the keyword golden ratio, but it doesn't always work. It's a good way to estimate. And the thing is, when you're talking about the keyword golden ratio, we're playing at the very end of the graph of the long tail, right? We're talking about very few searches, and it's a little bit easier to compete because we know that less people are going after those keywords just by default. So anyway, the KC number is a good way to sort of rank keywords against each other within Longtail Pro. But if you go in and you think that you're going to be able to rank a term just because it has a low KC number, you may be really surprised. So I'll get off my soapbox and tell you that the other stuff in Longtail Pro is actually great. I haven't used this cloud version until now. And the last few times that I used Longtail Pro, this was a couple years ago, it was very buggy. And I'm happy to report that it's not buggy anymore. They've done a great job rebuilding the tool, adding the cloud version out here versus, you know, the local version that people used to have, the client on their own machine. I feel like every time I tried to use it in the past, I had to update it over and over and over. And then it wouldn't provide any data. And I know basically all the people that I came up with, that I started sites with, no one uses Longtail Pro except like one person that I know of. Everyone uses a different tool because Longtail Pro a couple years ago was just really buggy. It was really hard to use and unreliable. Okay, that said, as I'm scrolling down, we see just generally, you know, we got 20 keywords, which is interesting. And then we have the KC number. We have the search volume, which is the main thing that we're interested in, right? Like the search volume is kind of like the basis of where a lot of our research starts. Now, it does look like best is used in every single one or most of them here, at least half of them or so. And as we scroll down, we see that the KC number is highlighted. If it's like under 25, it's in green, which is reported as good. And then we have, you know, under 30, it's yellow. Over 30, it's not marked at all. Okay. The bid is the CPC number, which applies to, like AdWords, right? So we don't care about that. The number of words is listed, the rank value, which the rank value is the estimated monthly value of ranking at the top position. It's calculated by using AdWords and the suggested bid and an estimated click-through rate. And actually, like if you're an Amazon affiliate, like I don't think this data holds true. So I believe if you ranked number one for best fishing rods, you'd make a whole heck of a lot more than $6.80. So I think this is an interesting idea, but it's really hard to make that sort of estimate. And I think what's listed here is mainly for AdWords. It doesn't really apply for Amazon affiliate. And I think if you wanted to do it, you would have to put in your own custom data, as they note here. A custom visitor value is how you would figure that out. Okay. And next, what we can do is, so suggestions per keyword. So we had 20 here initially, and I'm going to do the same search. And then I'm going to say, I want the maximum 400 and retrieve them. Okay, so it's taking just a moment here to work, and I'm not going to cut out any of the time here. Okay, so it took maybe 3 or 4 seconds to pull the data, which I think is plenty fast enough. It's now calculating the KC score for us, which is, again, you know, a good thing to have relative to other terms. Okay, so this is cool. And what we can do, hopefully, I'm going to click on this volume and see if it resorts it, which it does. So it resorted it and it gives us, you know, 400 keywords. There are 50 shown here. There's no filters right now. So let's go ahead and filter based on, you know, they give us some good tools here, similar to SEMrush. And you can include certain keywords, you can exclude certain keywords, you can filter or sort by the KC number or the search volume or whatever. So I'm going to say just keywords containing best. And then I'm going to say exclude any search volumes greater than, we'll say 2,500, just so we get sort of lower volume. And I'll hit apply. We'll see how long it takes. Just a second here, it looks like. So now we have a sorted list. It is unclear how many are actually sorted out because 418 are still listed here. So it's really kind of unclear, but we do have sort of a tighter list of buyers' keywords. So next, what I would probably do is export this, and you know, I'd be able to look at it a little more closely in like Excel or something. But let's see what happens with the customized. So we could actually get rid of the bid since we don't care about that, and click save. So it cleans it up just a little bit. One other thing, a quick note: if you're interested in the keyword golden ratio, here's a little tip for you. So exclude the number of words if it is less than 4. So we're only getting 4 or greater, or it looks like they're doing 5 or greater. But anyway, we got rid of a bunch of others and we're now looking at longer phrases, which tend to be closer for keyword golden ratio. And since the filter isn't a, you know, what I would call like a strict math, they kind of are generous and liberal with their less than and equal to. I'm a math guy, so that kind of stuff's important to me. Less than and less than and equal to are very different. So anyway, I would look for 4 or more, and that sorts it out pretty well. Hit export, and then you could, you know, take it to Excel and do a little more manipulation. You could look these things up. If you have a VA, you could have them look up your keyword golden ratio scores. Okay. For rank tracking, you obviously would put in the stuff that you're tracking, the keywords, and then it would give you the information here. Personally, if I was using Longtail Pro, this would be a convenient tool. However, here's the problem, right? I use a tool called serplab.co.uk, and you can get like quite a few keywords tracked for free. And then if you pay like $5 a month, you can get, you know, hundreds tracked. So for me, that's all I really need. And I don't do a ton of keyword research, so I wouldn't need the tool all the time, right? So I probably wouldn't track my keywords using Longtail Pro because I'm not doing like full-time keyword research where I need to pay, you know, $37 a month all the time. All right. And then after that, another couple quick notes. So you have the billing and settings here. You have the billing information. You have video tutorials, which is cool. I'll just click open that in another tab. And then you have monthly keywords remaining. So you can only pull, it looks to be like 10,000 keywords and rank tracking URLs remaining. So you can only track 30 terms and you can only do it on 2 URLs. So it's quite limited if you ask me, but if you were using Longtail Pro already and if you have the budget to pay $37 a month, it would be a fine way to track some of your keywords. But a lot of times if I'm doing keyword golden ratio work, I'm tracking hundreds of keywords, right? So it would be kind of like cost prohibitive and I would have to use serplab.co.uk anyway, and it's cheaper. So I wouldn't use Longtail Pro for rank tracking. Now, back in the day before like SERP Lab was out there, SERP Book was out there, it was harder to, you know, track your keywords, and Longtail Pro did it for you. So it was useful, but you couldn't track as many keywords. But those days are different now. So as we look at some of the lessons here, this is a long tail boot camp. And I think this has been out for a little while, but you can see there is well over, you know, an hour plus, probably close to 2 hours and 14 lessons. I haven't watched any of these. I'm sure they're fine and they're going through like long tail stuff. They talk about link building strategies and so on and so forth. So I'm sure it's fine, but I bet my YouTube content may be better. So anyway, I hope you enjoyed this demo of Longtail Pro. It seems to be a very clean tool that you can use. You can get the search volumes. I believe it's, you know, accurate. I believe it's quick and fast. And the main complaints that I had with Longtail Pro in the past were mainly around just usability. It would just crash constantly. But with this new cloud version, which isn't even that new, it's just the first time I've used it, it's pretty good. And I would say if you're using Longtail Pro, it's a fine tool to use.